details of the National Credit Amendment Bill have actually been given, and Parliament announced last week that President Cyril Ramaphosa has actually signed this into effect, which means that it should now be law. So what does the Debt Relief Bill actually seek to do? At the moment, it has given a lot of powers to the National Credit Regulator to actually write off a number of debts for South Africans that earn less than 7,500 rand. So if you are a South African earning less than 7,500 rand and you have an unsecured loan for 50,000 rand and below, for example, the NCR can actually write that off. The bill itself met a bit of opposition, particularly from the banks and the Democratic Alliance, because their reasoning is that Banking Association has actually done a lot in the past to actually help with debt relief and has actually written off some debts in some past and has actually been working to create some mechanisms and some tools to help over indebted South Africans. And the other big worry at the moment is that if you are starting to write off certain loans, then it might encourage people to actually go off and start getting loans from more informal sources, such as your loan sharks, for example, or mashonisas. And they're saying that unsecured lending, especially from people that are unregulated, would not be safe for South Africans. They actually argue that by writing off certain types of debts, banks will then have to mitigate their risk. And how do they do this? They will likely increase some of the thresholds for lending, or they might increase interest rates so that they can reduce their risks. Because if you're giving money to someone who might end up having it written off by the NCR, for example, the banks need to be able to make room for that type of risk. And how do they do that? They do that by increasing interest rates as one of their tools. So how did we actually find ourselves here? How did South Africa get to this particular point where the 2005 National Credit Act had to be amended? Well, the big thing at the moment is the fact that so many South Africans are currently over indebted or overextended financially. Other calculations actually show that there are about 9 million South Africans that would have their debts erased if this particular bill was to continue forward as planned, and that 20 billion rand would actually end up being just written off and just disappearing. Because for a lot of people, your income stays the same, but your expenses are increasing at a much higher rate than your income is. And that's how South Africans end up getting into what's called a debt trap.